St. Joseph Convent High School, Champion Reefs KGF, in collaboration with Golden TV online news channel, proudly presents SSLC Super Scorer. Dear students, important exam-oriented questions are answered to enhance qualitative scoring of marks, aiming to achieve 10% result with the maximum number of toppers. The videos are designed very creatively to enable you to grasp the contents and concepts of each chapter easily with high definition animation pictures, video clips, and with a wide range of special effects. Children, make the best use of the videos and face the exam confidently. Wishing you all the very best for the forthcoming SSLC examination 2021.
Hello children, I'm Mrs. Kirtana from St. Joseph Convent High School, Champion Reef, KGF. I'm delighted to see you all through this video. Children, today we will be discussing some of the important concepts and question answers from the second chapter in Chemistry, Acids, Bases and Salts.
Chemistry is a scientific discipline involved with elements and compounds composed of atoms, molecules and ions. Their composition, structure, properties, behavior and the changes they undergo during a reaction with other substances. Now, we will study the reactions of acids and bases, how acids and bases cancel out each other's effects and many more interesting things that we use and see in our day-to-day life. Question number one, what are acids? Give some examples.
The answer is, the substances that produce hydronium ions in water are called acids. Hydrogen ion combines with water to form hydronium ion. Examples: A. Acetic acid in vinegar. B. Methanoic acid in ant sting, nettle leaves. C. Citric acid in citrus fruits like lemon, oranges, etc. D. Lactic acid in curd. E. Oxalic acid in tomato. F. Tartaric acid in tamarind. Question number two, what are bases? The answer is, the substances that produce hydroxyl ions are called bases. Magnesium hydroxide in water gives magnesium ion and hydroxyl ion. Water-soluble bases are called alkalis. Some examples for bases are A. Calcium hydroxide, lime water. B. Sodium hydroxide or potassium hydroxide is used in soap. C. Ammonium hydroxide found in window cleaner. D. Magnesium hydroxide in milk of magnesia. Question number three, what is neutralisation? The answer is, the reaction between an acid and base to give a salt and water is known as neutralization reaction. An example for neutralization reaction is, sodium hydroxide reacts with hydrochloric acid to form salt, that is sodium chloride and water. An important question, question number four. Why does dry HCl gas not change the color of the dry litmus paper? The answer is, dry HCl gas does not contain any H+ ions, so it does not show any acidic property. Hence, it does not change the color of dry litmus paper. In dry HCl, there is no H+ ions because there is no moisture or water molecules for hydrochloric acid to be dissociated into H+ and Cl- ions. Therefore, H+ ions are not available to change the color of the litmus paper. Question number 5. What is pH scale? The answer is a scale for measuring hydrogen ion concentration in a solution is called pH scale. pH value between 0 and 7 is acidic, pH value 7 is neutral, pH value above 7 to 14 is a base. The pH of a neutral solution is 7. Values less than 7 on the pH scale represent an acidic solution. As the pH value increases from 7 to 14, it represents an increase in the hydroxyl ion concentration in the solution. Question number 6. What happens if too much of acid is produced in the stomach? What is the remedy for this? The answer is, during indigestion, the stomach produces too much acid and this causes pain and irritation. To get rid of this pain, people use bases called antacids. Antacids neutralize the excess acid. Our stomach produces hydrochloric acid, which helps in the digestion of food. Excess of hydrochloric acid causes hyperacidity. Antacid, being basic in nature, neutralizes the excess of acid and gives relief from pain caused by hyperacidity. Question number 7. How is tooth decay related to pH? How can it be prevented? The answer is, tooth decay starts when the pH of the mouth is lower than 5.5. Bacteria present in the mouth produce acids by degradation of sugar and food particles remaining in the mouth after eating. The best way to prevent this is to clean the mouth with toothpaste after eating, as toothpaste is a base. Tooth enamel is made up of calcium hydroxyapatite. It is the hardest substance in the body. It does not dissolve in water but is corroded when the pH in the mouth is below 5.5, that is acidic. Toothpaste is a base which neutralizes the excess acid and prevents tooth decay. Question number 8. What is chlor-alkali process? The answer is, electrolytic decomposition of sodium chloride is called chlor-alkali process. Sodium chloride reacts with water to form sodium hydroxide, chlorine gas and hydrogen gas. When electricity is passed through an aqueous solution of sodium chloride, it decomposes to form sodium hydroxide. The process is called chlor-alkali process because of the products formed. Chlor for chlorine and alkali for sodium hydroxide. Question number 9. How is bleaching powder prepared? Write its uses. The answer is, bleaching powder is produced by the action of chlorine on calcium hydroxide, that is slaked lime. Calcium hydroxide reacts with chlorine to form bleaching powder, that is CaOCl2, and water. Uses: A. For bleaching cotton, wood pulp, paper and clothes. B. Has oxidizing agent in many chemical industries. C. To make drinking water free from germs. An important question, question number 10. Mention the uses of baking soda. The answer is A. Used for making baking powder. B. Used in antacids. C. It is also used in soda acid fire extinguisher. Question number 11. Explain the preparation of plaster of Paris. Write its uses. The answer is, plaster of Paris is prepared by heating gypsum to 373 Kelvin. Gypsum on heating to 373 Kelvin becomes plaster of Paris and water. Uses: A. It is used for making toys and materials for decoration. B. For supporting fractured bones. C. To make surfaces smooth. Question number 12. What is water of crystallization? The answer is, water of crystallization is a fixed number of water molecules present in one formula unit of a salt. For example, copper sulfate crystals, which seem to be dry, contain water of crystallization and is blue in color. When we heat the crystals, this water is removed and the salt turns white. If we moisten the crystals again with water, we find that the blue color of the crystal reappears. Question number 13. Plaster of Paris should be stored in a moisture-proof container. Why? The answer is, plaster of Paris absorbs moisture to form a hard solid known as gypsum. Children, here are some important questions as home assignment in the examination point of view. First one, why should curd and sour substances not be kept in brass or copper vessel? Question 2. Draw the diagram of the arrangement of apparatus to know the reaction of zinc granules with dilute sulfuric acid and testing hydrogen gas. Question number 3. Write the uses of washing soda. Question number 4. Name the gases produced during chlor-alkali process and mention their uses. Question number 5. Draw a neat diagram to show that acid solution in water conducts electricity.
Children, I hope you have learned the important question and answers from the lesson. Thank you for watching this video. If you have any doubts, you can contact me. Children, prepare well for your exams. Thank you.